because my word tells me I'm supposed to be ready all the time, instant in season and out of season, to make the altar call. You know, I was talking to the saints, you know, and we know the provisions God has made for us, but maybe somebody doesn't know. Hallelujah. You don't know him like that to where you can trust him, that you can cast your cares on him, that you can rely on him. And if that's you, you need to come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And if everybody would please stand, hallelujah. And when you come, I'm going to ask our pastors and our altar workers to come and minister and lay hands on you. And maybe you do know the Lord, but maybe life is kind of beating you up because you forgot to do some of these things. And you want to rededicate your life to the Lord and say, Lord, I want to get it right. I want to experience that fullness of joy. I want to experience that peace that you promised. I want to know that assurance that Sister Candy and Sister Hill and others in the ministry have. If that's you, come on. Hallelujah. The devil may have, hallelujah, brought attack against your body, even though he didn't have any dominion over you. Hallelujah. And maybe you didn't know that just because he brings it, you don't have to accept it. And if that's you, come on down for healing. Hallelujah. And maybe you're just walking, hallelujah, in it all. All is going well for you, and you just want to say, thank you, Lord. Just raise your hand now and just thank him for all that he's done. Praise him for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men, for the things and the great things that he's doing in your life. Lord, we want to thank you, hallelujah, for your word. This word is an effectual word. Hallelujah. This word is your word and your truth, and it stands and it remains forever. Hallelujah. And we thank you that we are reaping the benefits and the fullness of the blessings that are contained therein. Father, we give you praise and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. I've been asked to do a quick word of prayer for Sister Judy. And we know, hallelujah, the great things that, we remember the great things that God has already done for Sister Judy. And I'm sure that Sister Judy remembers the great things that God has done for her. Hallelujah, that he is continuing to do in her life. But we just want to plead the blood of Jesus, hallelujah, over that situation. Hallelujah. We want to thank God, hallelujah, for making her complete and making her whole. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ that cleansed not only Sister Judy, but us from all unrighteousness. Hallelujah. Because we've been cleansed, hallelujah, we can accept what the Son has done and the healing that he has provided for our bodies. Hallelujah. I thank you for making every fiber in her body whole. Hallelujah. I thank you for encouraging her, for strengthening her, for healing her. Hallelujah. For restoring her. Hallelujah. To the woman that you created her to be. Hallelujah. Full of power, full of energy, full of love, full of ability. Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah. Your word is yea and amen. And by your stripes, Sister Judy is healed. Amen.
Amen, amen. That word was rich, wasn't it? Amen. Beautiful, beautiful. Sister Candy, thank you so much. I tell you, I'm not going to try to recap. I just took it all in. We're going to let you go, but it was just wonderful. Don't we have some talented ladies around here? Amen. We're just so thankful. On Mother's Day, we heard Sister Deborah, and she was excellent. Sister Candy was excellent. And we've heard different ones in the ministry, how, and Sister Denise, is she still here? As she spoke on, amen, Sister Denise, anointed vessel of the Lord, and there are others who have just shared, and I tell you, God is just good. Sister Wayne blesses us, all of you bless us. And I'm just going to say briefly, Sister Candy gave us the ingredients that's necessary. I know Pastor Hill is back there rejoicing now, because she just really reinforced what he's been preaching for many years. And Sister Candy, don't you ever think that you don't have what Brother Williams had. Don't ever think that anymore. Amen. I told you she was full of the Word. She's a student of the Word. We see how God has endowed her. So we are just so grateful for that. And I just wanted to say that I hope this didn't fall on deaf ears, because she has challenged each one of us and given us the what each one of those represent, T-R-U-S-T, and I'm not going to review it because hopefully you took notes like I did. But if you follow that, your life can be victorious. I mean, you knew it already, but how many of you know that to hear it from somebody else, sometimes it makes a difference? Follow that. And as she was speaking, I thought of the psalmist. I'm just going to do this one scripture. In Psalms 119, and I believe it's 92, that says, unless the law had been my delight, hallelujah, I would have perished in my afflictions. Unless the law had been my delight. See, you got to make the law the delight of your heart. Then when those afflictions that come, that she talked about so well, delineated so well in her message, when the afflictions come, you won't perish. Praise God. So we want to just challenge you to take that word in, absorb it. She gave you something that will, you can feast on all this week, the week to come, and the months to come, and the years to come. Thank you so much, Sister Candy. Now then, we don't want Pastor... Can you come and just stand? He doesn't want to do anything, so I'll do it. We want to bless Sister Candy. She's getting ready next week to go on a vacation. Now, I know you've already given, but you heard her talk about giving of yourself. There was a lot of aspects of giving that she didn't mention, but what I'm going to talk about was giving of your resources, your money. She's gone up there, going on vacation, and we want them to enjoy themselves. They have been very, very faithful, and I want to raise a really good offering for Sister Candy today. I don't have an envelope, but I have my check ready. I want you, we know that sometimes you say, well, I had this aside for this reason or what have you. I want you to dig deep and get ready to give, and I'll give you time to write your checks or whatever, and get your envelope prepared. As you're doing that, let me just say to Sister Dorothy, who is our President of Women of Excellence, let's give her a hand. Job well done. Amen. She pulled this all together. She asked me to do something, and I said, no, I don't want to do anything. I wasn't obstinate, but didn't I tell you, Sister Dorothy? I did. I said, no, I'm going to sit down and enjoy it. But I have thoroughly enjoyed the lady. So my Sister Bice, is she still in the house? Yeah, there she is. Beautiful prayer, Sister Bice. And then Sister Shirley came back with a beautiful scripture. And Sister Anita, I tell you, I thought she was going to kind of preach on that scripture. I like that, Sister. Oh, Anita, that was good. And just everything was so wonderful. And we had a special treat this morning. Sister Babette Edwards came in and just really, really. Sister Babette is, let me see if I can remember, from Maryland?
Yes.
All the way from Maryland. How many of you remember when she was here as a student? A few of you. One, two, three, four. But Sister Babette, let me just mention this. She was, at the time that she was here, we had a Northside paper, Northside Chronicles. She was the editor and all, and we had a paper for, I think it was bi-monthly, and I had it for a number of years. So she made some really rich deposits here in this ministry. And every time she has an opportunity to come back to be with us, she comes by. So we're so glad to have you, Sister Edwards. Amen. Also, I want to just say a little bit about Justice. He's gone, but did he do well? Amen. He is in the orchestra at Carver, and he has first chair. And he received honors, about two or three honors, and his instructor said, never in the history of the school had they gotten that honor, and but Justice brought that honor to the school. So we're proud of Justice for that. He loves that instrument. And again, I want to thank each one of you. As you come, would you stand, please? Pastor said he's just going to sit in the back. Going to let him sit back there. Praise God. So just stand as you and come and give. We ask you to give generously. Now, it's not very often that we're able to get an offering for Sister Candy. I want her to be tremendously blessed. You bless me whenever you give to me. I want to be even more of a blessing to Sister Candy. Amen? Amen? Father God, we thank you today for this service. We just thank you for your servants who have given out of their hearts. And we just thank you for just blessing us today. And we ask that you bless each one that's giving. We ask that you just bless them multifold as they live out of their need. And we will be so careful to give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus. Amen. Bless this offering. Amen. Would you come at this time? And as you're coming, we don't have a musician. Our musician has gone. He had another commitment. But you come, we just march as though we have music here. Okay. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent one from another. Amen. You're dismissed. Thank you. Sister Candy has a comment. Okay.
Really, really quick. This is for the Sunday school class. Remember, you were talking about how people fell for that nut that said the world was in your sight. I don't understand how that does. I just want to make sure you got it. They fell for it because you'll fall for anything. They didn't know. You'll fall for anything. You know, there's been other people that have fallen. You know, remember when everybody in the nation was going with Oprah on that book on how to be spiritual, and all that was going with that nut that had the hot house? And you know, not knocking no Oprah, but I learned some good things from Oprah. I learned that I didn't need grease in my hair. I learned how to buy undergarments. Hallelujah. And I learned how to cook spinach to where I like it. Hallelujah. And if she has a class on how to run a business successfully, I might sign up for that. But I don't have to say, Oprah, stick with what you know. Like they say on Finding Nemo, you think you know these things, but you don't. Glory to God. I really appreciate the Sunday school class.